Hello and welcome to the Calumet Wilderness with Sam Love. I am your host, Sam Love. We're going to get right to business today. Last video, we looked at the public land survey system. Now we're going to look at how we can use that system to interpret information from old maps. Very quickly though, first, if you haven't already, please click that subscribe button. And thank you to everyone who has, who's been leaving comments, likes, and sharing. I really do appreciate that. Now, I've got two questions to accompany this deep dive into the old maps. The first is, where exactly was the confluence of Turkey Creek and Deep River? The second, when I took a kayak journey in late September down Lake George, was I actually in a part which historically was Turkey Creek? So you can see here a screenshot I made near the confluence. You can see a screenshot I made when I realized I couldn't go on any farther. That's a whole different story. And you can see here a photograph of what it looked like from the water. Well, a great place to start is spicerweb.org. And of course, I'll put a link in the description below. This is done by Steve Spicer, who lives in Miller. And while his page is mostly focused on Miller, he's got maps going back to the late 18th century all the way through the 19th century. And most of these maps actually capture most of Lake County, even Cook County, Porter County, and beyond. So this is a fantastic research. Most of the links still work. There's a couple of bum ones in there, but otherwise, this is just such a great and useful tool. So thank you very much, Steve, for doing this. Let's get to the maps. First up, from 1840, is the descriptive map of unsold lands in Lake County. This was produced by none other than Solon Robinson, the founder of Crown Point. This is a well-detailed map showing ecosystems, some of the earliest settlements, paths and trails, and of course, it uses the public land survey system. So this is kind of our starting point here. This is sort of our first glimpse as to what the landscape and the terrain of Northwest Indiana would have looked like just before the middle of the 19th century. The next map is from the 1860s. This is Colton's map of the state of Indiana. Although the great thing about this map is it actually has the adjoining counties. So you can get the Chicago part of the Calumet region in this map. Very rare to find bi-state maps. So this doesn't have really as much ecological information. Some of the major waterways and things like that are shown. But other than that, what's really useful here, though, is you can see the development of the region during the Civil War era, what communities existed at that time, as well as some of the roads that were being developed in the region around that time. Now, one caveat about communities on these maps. There's a reason why I often say the map is not the territory. These cartographers often were not local. They were going on information that was sometimes inaccurate. So on this map, we see mention of an Indiana city, which never existed. We see a city west, which by the time this map was made, no longer existed. And we also see a new city west, which probably never existed. So we have to combine visual information with text information and many other sources to get the history. Next up, we have the 1874 Hardesty sectional map of Lake County. This is a phenomenal map, highly detailed. You can really get lost in this one because it has property owner information. So not as much environmental information, but nevertheless, it's a great way to see how the region had developed after the Civil War. Well, 2 years later, we have the Andreas map of Lake County. And, you know, the Hardesty's map is a tough act to follow. I mean, this 1876 map doesn't have a fraction of the information that the 1874 map has. But one thing I do like about this source is it has a really detailed map of the town of Hobart. And you can see the original mill pond and the original downtown there. And finally, from 1897, rounding out the 19th century, there is the geological map of Lake and Porter counties. And what I really love about this map, you have all the infrastructure information, but there is also ecological information where some of the old beaches even were located. So really cool map. I like the colors on this one as well. So those are my top five. I wanted to focus on ones that have high resolution scans and are free. So head over to spicerweb.org. There's a lot more stuff on there. You can really get lost in there. All right, so let's tackle our questions. Where was exactly the confluence of Turkey Creek and Deep River? And more recently, did I make it into what was historically Turkey Creek when I took my kayak trip last September? So using the public land survey system, I know I'm looking at Township 35 North, Range 8 West, Section 1. So let's check out the old maps. Solon Robinson's 1840 map gives us some environmental information. You can see Deep River to the right. You can see Turkey Creek to the left. There's two tributaries of Turkey Creek, one to the north and one to the south. And there's a small wetland on the left side of this particular section. It looks like the confluence of Turkey Creek and Deep River is kind of in that northeastern section there, kind of in the upper left. Colton's map from the 1860s has even less information. That northern tributary of Turkey Creek is gone. The southern one is there in section two. And it looks like the confluence is in about the same place. Now, did the area actually look like this in the 1860s? Well, the map can't tell us that exactly. Hardesty's 1874 map shows us property owners at the time, so that's interesting. You can even see where a few buildings are, but there's less environmental information. And notice that the confluence of Turkey Creek and Deep River has actually shifted to the upper left corner. Now, is this a case of, you know, rivers do move over time, or is this more of a case that the cartographer never actually set foot here in Northwest Indiana and just sort of did the best they could? Well, that's why I always say the map is not the territory. The 1876 Andreas map, it barely has any information, although you do see, I think that might be a road down there at the bottom. You can see the confluence there is right in the center. Let's get to the next map. This is the 1897 geological map of Lake County and Porter County. And here you can see there is a road. That's Arizona and Decatur right there, right by the Bulbur Oak Preserve. And again, it looks like that confluence is in the upper right-hand corner, the northeast corner there. Now let the real fun begin. Let's go to IHAPI. This is a 1939 aerial image. And you can see it looks like as it does today. Moved to 1954. You can't really make out a whole lot of detail on these. The scans just aren't as high res as the maps are as we get ready to jump to 1958. But, you know, using the maps and the aerial photographs, you know, we're able to get this history, but it still leaves me with the question of sort of what happened to that original confluence of Turkey Creek and Deep River. In other words, when did it become Lake George? Here is... Now, this is an interesting one here. This is 1973 when there was a giant staple connecting the two banks of Deep River. I'll bet you didn't know that. That's some very interesting local history right there. Don't know what happened to that giant staple, but it lives on in this map, which is not the territory. Well, let's jump ahead to 2022 in a Google image here. Of course, Google has aerial imagery going back to the 90s, but we don't really need that right now. What I find interesting on this map from randymajors.org, though, is that it doesn't show Lake George. It actually shows a thin creek. Put a pin down here, kind of representing as far as I got during that kayak journey in September. And here you can see satellite imagery, which, you know, it looks like a proper lake here. Here's a view from the water. That tree line back there is where Turkey Creek continues on. Now, if this had been later in the spring or earlier in the summer, it would look much more open. But, you know, looking at this, these historical images, these historical maps, you know, I think it's safe to say I made it to where historical Turkey Creek was. And we'll plan to get back to when the right season arrives. So, well, thank you for joining me at this look at old maps and the public land survey system. Hope this helps you find the history of where you live. And I'll see you around in the next episode of the Calumet Wilderness. Until then, appreciate your landscape. Take care. Bye.